disrobing here tonight in this fine establishment. But now here comes my favorite part of the show. This is the part I call armed robbery. So I want you to put your wallets, your rings, other nice things on the table in front of you. Come on, now. Come on, in the hat. Let's go. You be real good to me now, okay? You be real good to me, and you're gonna have a nice tale to tell all your grandkitties. One warning, though. When things go haywire, I kill people.
Here's what I say. I say this. I say do what the pretty lady says. That's your best policy, safety-wise. Sorry, Sam. Excuse me. That's Will. Will keeps his money in a clip hid up in his shorts.
Oh, is that true, Plowboy?
Damn it, Elton, I'm gonna kick you!
We don't want any trouble. Elton and me.
Elton's okay. The fact is, he teaches gun safety clinics to the kids around here, volunteers his time and expertise. Now, he could shoot the eye right out of a flying crow.
He could, but he wouldn't. I'm his parole officer. I know him. I know him. Elton just wouldn't do something like this. It's not in his nature.
But he killed his father.
He was just a kid. Plenty of extenuating circumstances. Ancient history.
Recent history, armed robbery last night.
I can't explain that. That's why I asked for a marshal.
And that's why I'm here. I'm just gonna catch him as fast as I can.
I heard about this guy. He's a big-time retriever.
Good. Elton, he's big-time help. Woman just loves a man. Lots and lots of firepower. She feels safe.
Well, I like the pain targets.
So how come you have all this stuff way out here and not?
Well, much like it when folks poke around my hobbies and stuff. There's no such thing as an unloaded gun.
Look at these guys are ready to crucify Elton. I want you to understand, he's really a very sweet guy.
Sweet? How we doing?
Good, Sheriff. You want to give us a couple minutes alone? Thank you.
Well, he could have charged the city for those gun clinics of his. Never even occurred to him.
He loves quiet things. Nature. He made me a little gift once. A chipmunk he whittled out of wood from Alabaster Cavern. See?
He killed his father.
Elton's dad was a short order cook on a military base. He used to lock Elton in the closet and beat him within an inch of his life. I don't mean whipped him, I mean beat him.
He assaulted two state employees on the way to the orphanage, was convicted of homicide. From there, he went to a boys' facility. Then from there, he went to Maxim for another couple years. And the only reason they cut him loose when he was 21 was because they had to by law, even though the prison shrink still thought he was unstable.
People say what they want to say.
Who's this?
That's his mom. She died giving birth to Elton. Elton's special. He's seen violence. He knows what it is. He hates it. Baby carriage. Elton loves a swap meet.
Does he have a girlfriend?
Tell you the truth, I don't think he's ever been with a woman.
Never? Virgin.
are so fluid, Elton.
A gift, I guess. From God, I guess.
Do you have kids?
Yes, I do. Two little girls, one with a birthday day after tomorrow.
I have dogs. I'd like to have kids.
Yeah.
I'm trying to adopt, actually.
Well, that can't be very easy, single woman job like yours.
Tell me about it. The adoption people aren't making it any easier. It's not like I even carry my gun.
Aim her careful. Now say to yourself, squeeze with ease.
Squeeze with ease.
Squeeze with ease.
Squeeze with ease. Squeeze with ease.
Very good, Sherry.
Very good. I didn't even hit anything.
Oh, important thing is you didn't flinch. Well, you got natural instinct.
Hell, I was gonna shoot her. I didn't care. Then that kid grabbed my gun, went off, hit my foot.
What you get for trying to give somebody a break?
How is your foot, Mr. Garmo?
Hit more boot than toe. Thank the Lord for painkillers.
We're gonna need a photo of the little cowgirl from last night.
No, I don't have one. Why would I? Now, every picture you see on the wall is a pro, bona fide. Pros is all I hang on my wall. We don't have no pictures of amateurs around here, do we, Marie?
Hey, no pictures, Mr. G.
You know, you shouldn't drink with those.
Right.
She's right. You should.
I feel like Scrooge McDuck. He just loved to play with his money, just like me. Hey. Woo! You, me and you, crime partners. Come here. Let's consummate it. Come on. I'm what you always wanted and never had.
Like a real life sinful.
I won't buy it, I promise. I lied!
She's definitely a professional. This is professional equipment. See, notice that little tearaway feature there?
She's 38, DC cup. Maybe more.
Can you tell us anything else besides her measurements?
Yeah, great sense of rhythm. The way she moved, the way she hit me. Believe you me, that girl had rhythm.
Do you think Elton and her knew each other?
Cahoots right down, smallest detail.
Yeah, she was definitely a pro.
Do you think Elton and the new dancer knew each other?
Did they know each other? Oh, of course not. It was a chance meeting.
Sort of like two ships passing in the night?
Sure. If they're both the Titanic.
All right. Mr. Garmo's peephole peeps right into the dressing room.
He takes pictures through the peephole.
Shows them to his pals. He's been good to me, but let's face it, Mr. G's a pervert.
Hmm. Can anyone else confirm that?
Yeah, Garmo and I are pals.
Oh yeah, look at this. The bikini bra was custom made by Great Assets of Hollywood, a store catering exclusively to the sex trade.
Elton's traveling with a Sherry Fleming, AKA Sherry Prairie, ex-nude dancer, a pro. People I talked to said she talked about going to New Orleans someday. Maybe that day's today.
Is there a fax that tells us why Elton ended up with a woman like Sherry Prairie heading for a city he's never been to?
Well, I'll tell you what, Miss Steenburgen, tomorrow afternoon when I catch him, I'll ask him myself.
I'll get the air search started.
I'm sorry, Marshal, I've got to go. I've got a hearing at an adoption board.
Oh, go ahead. Yeah, this is a piece of cake here. Everything will be fine. As a matter of fact, I think I'll make it home in time for my daughter's birthday.
Hope you're right.
Good luck.
Thanks.
Please don't hurt us. Take anything you want. It's all yours.
Guns don't kill people. People kill people. Responsibility is everybody's top concern.
And the first head that pops out that door is a deadhead. Okay? See ya.
See ya.
I've got money in the bank. But come with me, you can have it all for me.
Don't blink. The business world is changing so fast, you might miss something. It's a world in which business as usual can put you out of business. Where you have to be more things to more people, or you can bet someone else will. This is the world UPS works in, which is why we do more than simply deliver packages. We do things others can't. From barcoding your inventory, to helping you warehouse it. From tracking around the world, to delivering around the corner. Like you, we have to wear a lot of hats. Ours just all happen to be brown. UPS, moving at the speed of business.
Remember the Hollywood lash? The spiked lash? Even doe eyes? You ain't seen nothing. Today, Revitalizing by Maybelline reinvents mascara with a unique Sable Soft Brush. Actually finds lashes you never knew you had, then enriches them with vitamin E and silk.
Till you try it, you ain't seen nothing yet.
Look for Revitalizing Mascara only in the Revitalizing section. By Maybelline.
As sure as the sun will rise across America, the families that travel will have one common need: to be safe. So it's no surprise that America's favorite full-size car has also been honored for safety. That's according to Prevention Magazine, which gave the Sabre the Safe Car Achievement Award in the full-size category. Buick LeSabre, the American family, family car.
Maybe your business is so good, you can afford a slowdown. Because that's what can happen when you've got employees who use drugs. Fact is, drug users have almost doubled the absentee rate. So call for this free guide on how to set up a drug-free workplace. It's not hard to do. And it'll help keep things moving.
Things are heating up between Lois and Clark.
Clark, what are you waiting for?
But an old flame has come back from the dead.
Did you think I wouldn't come back for you?
Lex is back with a vengeance on an all-new Lois and Clark. Sunday, here on ABC.
They robbed the wigwam just over the border, Oklahoma.
Wasn't oddball to the nth degree, but he was calm. Look out, she was itchy to shoot.
Could you identify her?
I don't really want any trouble.
Well, I don't think that's a problem. They're probably halfway to Texas by now.
Yeah, it's her. And him. From last night, they just walked in.
Sherry, that was uncalled. You shot the caboose.
All right, you behind the bar. Let me see your hands now, or I swear to God, I will splatter this old dude's head like a Crenshaw melon.
I sense this is the ideal time to finish my beverage.
Hilton.
Ready when you are, Missy. Ready when you are. Splatter if you must.
There's no need for that.
I'm cooperating. We're all cooperating. Nice and easy. Nobody gets hurt. Elton, that's the way Miss Steenburgen would like it to be.
Steenburgen? You know Miss Steenburgen?
Who?
She was very proud of you, Elton. And now she's... Well, she's very sad.
She's an angel on earth. I have failed her.
Failed who?
No, you haven't failed her, Elton. Matter of fact, poor Sarah thinks she failed you and she'd... Well, she'd like you to come along with me and give her another chance to help you again.
No, Elton.
Well, please apologize to Miss Steenburgen. I want you to place the weapon careful-like on the bar, sir. Can't stress the word careful enough.
That's right. Do it. Damn it!
Okay, okay. All right, here's my weapon.
Thank you.
Stand up! That's right, come on, let me see your hands.
Sorry. We're gonna have to put y'all in the walk-in freezer.
This train's for my son, Elton Jr. Only thing he loves more than trains is his old man.
I never figured you as a dada.
Well, I guess you figured wrong, Sherry.
Nobody robs the same place twice in 12 hours.
He took the train.
Are you okay, Marshal?
Yes.
Two bandits traveling in broad daylight in a baby blue Cadillac.
Okay, so they hit the wigwam, snooze two blocks away.
Chuck, I think we can do without the comprehensive summary at this particular moment. Thank you very much. What do you got?
Antidepressants. He's been on four a day. They're really strong.
And he's running on empty. That is a worst case scenario if ever I heard of.
I want to expand the search, cover all of Oklahoma, take it in northwest Texas, even into New Mexico.
Marshal?
What?
We found this in the motel parking lot.
What is it?
A pasty. Could be hers.
Oh, look, it's a little Marshall badge.
What am I gonna do for a caboose? Train without a caboose.
Hey, that last rest stop we were at? Remember when I went to the toity? Well, there was this guy in the men's room that I took this off of.
Now, don't be pulling stuff I don't know about.
So maybe we can trade my gold watch for a bright red caboose. He cut me some slack. I didn't shoot him. I just hit him. Hard. Angel of yours, Miss Steinburgen.
She's my parole officer.
Why do you have a parole officer?
Killed somebody once.
Well, I'm sure he deserved it. Wasn't he, wasn't it? It wasn't a she.
He.
Well, I'm sure he probably had it coming, right?
No, he... I don't know.
Miss my daughter's birthday.
I
How did the adoption board go?
I got a second hearing. They always say no. Board's empty show of fairness. God, they ask about 1,000 questions. Never a right answer. Why don't you help me rehearse?
What?
Just ask me some questions.
Like what?
Anything.
What makes you think you'd make a good mom?
Well, there's a lot of children in the world that nobody wants, and I want a child. Now, I am willing to learn as I go, and I'm not afraid to admit when I'm wrong.
Baby on board.
No, I don't even care if it's a baby. It could be an older child.
Elton had a brand new baby carriage in his trailer.
I'm not picky. I'd have a boy or a girl or...
A brand new baby carriage and no baby.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about a baby carriage. Elton had a baby carriage in his trailer. No baby.
And you were right about that baby carriage. Elton had it on layaway. Made payments every week. Expensive, too.
Sarah, call Sheriff Wade. Elton worked in that cannery for 2 years. You must have had some form of communication with another human being.
Oh. I never saw this guy.
How about her?
Yeah, that's her. Meanest eyes I ever saw in a woman. I gave her what she wanted, then she started pistol whipping me. With ugly eyes.
Thanks. Sheriff Wade said that a former employee named Nancy Beeman used to, lunch with Elton.
Where is she?
She quit about 8 months ago, and nobody knows. She left town, and...
Spoke to my buddy in New Orleans Vice. Sherry called her pimp, said she'd be down there ready to work in 2 days.
We should get a pen register for the pimp's phone.
Already got it, right there. Tawny, Oklahoma. Chuck, I think we're gonna need a close parallel roadblock with a three-quarter wrap around here, here, and here.
Mighty long way to New Orleans.
Yeah, that's all right. That's all right.
Honey, I don't mean to criticize or anything, but... Isn't New Orleans south?
We're going to Kansas first.
No way! What do you think we are, Dorothy and Toto?
Elton Jr.'s in Kansas. I need to give him the train. I need to spend quality time. You understand?
Okay.
Marshal will continue in a moment here on ABC.
Well, forget New Orleans.
Why?
I took a dog leg north, hit a shop right in Manalusa.
Manalusa?
How much was that again?
$2,947.89.
$2,000.
Elton, sweetie, 30. I'll deal with this.
All right.
Okay.
Get her a seat.
Thank you.
He's an awful lot of baggage for a pretty girl like you to be carrying.
He's very useful.
Well, I could be more useful to you. Very useful.
Yeah, I'm sure you could be.
Step away from the register.
Now.
Over there, come on. Yeah, you're gonna be very useful. Here, you can keep the change. It's been a pleasure doing business with you.
The shooter. I know it. It's just not like him. It had to be her.
Doesn't matter who pulled the trigger. They're both killers in the eyes of the law. New Orleans PD tells me Sherry called her pimp again. Her exact words, be in New Orleans soon as I dump the moron.
Dump the moron? Does that mean discard or kill?
If I was a betting man, I'd say kill and discard. The pen register gave us the payphone number Sherry called from in Tyrone, Oklahoma.
That puts the Coachella River between them and our roadblock.
It's beautiful country. Elton couldn't pass that up.
Did you get a line on Nancy Beeman?
Yeah, she lives in Elk County, Kansas.
All right, get a hold of her. See if she knows anything. All right. Now, everything I've ever learned as a marshal tells me they're headed right into our roadblock, which means they're not. But I cannot afford not to keep this. Even though they're not, they might. You know what I mean?
Porky's Meats.
You robbed that guy so we'd have to leave Kansas, didn't you?
Didn't make sense for us to be paying for those guns.
You didn't just rob him, you killed him too.
Elton.
Look at me. Look at me.
What are you doing?
I'm giving you my eye detector test. Did you kill the gun guy? Yes or no? You flunked. I order you to surrender your weapon.
Surrender?
I know what you're thinking, sweetheart, but I could kill you before you even squeeze the trigger. My son's getting his choo-choo.
Well, we looking for a Cadillac or a Porky's meat truck. They hijacked a truck. Why'd they empty it?
Think we need some big rigs for a roadblock. Big enough to stop a truck.
You got it.
Guess you're prepared to meet your maker. Well, never you mind. You got years left to deliver your product to an appreciative public. You work for a good outfit. Little gal back there thinks I'm gonna kill you, but she's wrong. Those knots are tied special. Take you maybe 2 hours to get loose. Fair enough?
Thank you.
You nailed it. They were spotted headed this direction by a crop duster.
I'm sorry I got mad. I just need to see my boys all.
Well, once the heat is off, you know, we can come back and get them.
You're gonna blame me for the killing?
Self-defense.
A man ain't nothing if he's not a good father.
You got a snapshot of Elton Jr.?
Got a picture of his mama. You two look alike, kinda.
Get out of here. Me and her. Get real.
You get real. Wipe some of that slutty crap off your face.
Elton!
How can you wear all that stuff,
cut
huh?
Out.
Nancy hardly doesn't wear makeup.
Just get off of me! It's cards on the table time here, all right? Elton, we just don't get along. And that's okay. Maybe you should just go your way and I'll go mine. We can split the money.
I see through you like a Ziploc bag. I don't trust you, Sherry. I let you out of my sight again. You just get caught doing something stupid. And I'd be
implicated. Elton, I would never implicate you. You know that. I'm crazy about you.
And what do you want to split up for?
Step out of the vehicle. Keep your hands where I can see them. Keep your hands where I can see them.
Boy, am I glad to see you guys.
It's not that.
Face down.
Yes, sir.
Got it. This is getting very expensive.
Take him out.
On the ground.
All right, don't see any weapons.
Not them.
No, it's not.
Only these two crazies carjacked us. They traded our car for this truck.
Things like this only happen in this city.
I can't believe this. I mean, it's not even
paid for. I didn't get to use it.
I found some money, but no train.
He took it.
Took what?
Train. He told us it was for Elton Jr.
And they're in an off-road vehicle. Hell, they could be anywhere out there.
Well, many have tried and failed. It appears Nissan has found a cure for the common cold. Fast relief, see your nearest Nissan dealer. Lease the Pathfinder XEV6 with Sport Convenient Package, $319 a month for 24 months with $2,000 down.
Oh. It's not that unusual to spot one in Kansas,
but the great blue heron usually prefers bodies of water as opposed to this flatland.
You really ought to get your pills, dear.
See? They mate for life, they do. They pair up forever. You gonna scare the bird? Oh, there you go.
Sarah Steenbergen?
Nancy? You're expecting me?
Marsh McBride phoned three times already. Call him immediately, he says.
You're pregnant.
Oh, yes, ma'am. I think I'm way past pregnant.
Elton has a gift for his son. He's on his way to give it to him.
Listen, I really can't talk, McBride. Nancy's about ready to deliver.
Deliver what?
Elton Jr., I imagine.
I'm not naming this baby after Elton.
A baby?
I gotta go. I gotta go.
Sarah, calm down. Calm down.
Okay.
I think now would be a good time to leave.
Okay.
Look at you. You wouldn't know the first thing about being a mother.
Don't even ask me what I'm doing, because I don't know.
We only did it once, me and Elton, but once is all it took.
You didn't use protection?
I don't want protection. I wanted a baby. Oh, they're coming faster.
Give me your arm.
No. No. I feel guilty. I used him. I used. Mossy, I don't feel guilty though. Mossy, I feel happy. I feel really happy. I'm having a baby.
What do they think? I'm gonna mosey on up the driveway? They can stop me from seeing Elton Jr.?
No way, Jose.
Hey.
Quiet.
Come on. No. I want you to meet Nancy. I think you'll like her.
No, birth babies are slow. I'm ready.
My sister said she had her first in 17 minutes.
Jimmy, what can you tell me about Elton's mother? Cause of life, hobbies, religion, anything. When she baked the pie, was it peach, cherry? I need details. No time, less than an hour. Yeah, an hour.
We'll get an officer and take you to the hospital.
Grocery store.
Hey!
Oh. Don't use bad language around my little boy, okay, sweetheart?
Okay. Why did you break in? We're surrounded!
Why did they break in? We're surrounded.
What's the situation?
In a nutshell, downstairs, two fugitives. He's armed, she's hogtaped. Upstairs, two potential hostages. While they're moving inside, I say they're unaware of what's going on upstairs. That federal parole officer be armed.
No, she's not. She doesn't carry a weapon. And there may be three hostages up there.
Three?
Yeah. Where's the baby carriage?
What baby carriage?
Hey, look who's here. It's a wigwam guy, Miss Steenburgen's friend.
Great.
Hi.
Hi.
Mind if I come in?
Yeah.
I heard you're about to be a father, Elton. So I brought you a little gift.
Thanks.
About to be a father? You mean Elton Jr. doesn't even exist?
Well, shut up, Sherry. I thought he'd be born by now.
Oh. I also got your prescription refilled.
Thanks.
I'll have you know I am being held against my will.
Could you have a seat?
Sure.
You're being held for your own good, Sherry.
No, you do not hogtie a person for their own good, Elton. He's a kidnapper. You know that, don't you? That is what you are. We are wanted for murder. Don't
Shut
you understand
up,
that? Murder,
Sherry.
Which means we gotta get the hell out of here now. Do you understand what I'm saying?
All right.
Now, Elton.
There. You're free. Go. Go.
Sweetie.
What?
We can use your cop friend to get us out of here.
Elton, what do you think your mother'd say if she knew you were hanging around with the likes of Miss Sherry here?
I resent the hell out of that.
Please don't cuss.
I'm sorry.
Understand your mother sang in the choir, Elton. People say she had a voice like an angel.
Mama died giving me birth.
Yeah, and Elton thinks that I look just like his mama.
Yep.
Yeah.
You do. She is so pretty.
Give me a gun, sweetie.
Oh, I don't think that's such a good idea.
Elton, dear. Do you hear that? That's your baby, Elton. Yeah. Why don't you let me hold on to the gun? You can go upstairs and you can see your little boy. Okay? Elton.
Okay.
Okay. Stand up. Okay. Officer Friendly, we want a helicopter that can take us the hell out of here.
Miss Steenburgen, what are you doing here?
I came by to see Nancy. I thought you'd want me to look after her.
Elton?
Can I hold him?
Her. But Elton, you can't hold a baby with a gun.
Oh.
No, Elton, no! No! Elton, shoot him! Kill him, Elton!
Your baby's upstairs.
Elton, do it!
Don't do it.
Elton, kill him.
Hey, Elton. What do you say we put that train set together?
Kill him.
Okay.
No, Elton! Oh.
Careful, sir. There's no safety on that 44.
Okay. testifies against Sherry Prairie, they'll go easy on him. But he is going to have to go back to jail, sir. You know, Sheriff, I was thinking about your board hearing. If you wanted me to be there, I could.
I'd appreciate that. Did you ever zero in on a present for your daughter for her birthday?
No.
Good, because I got the perfect thing.
Next,
Lucas Burke.
The Marshal.
Been robbing local banks for the past year and a half.
Hey, I'm looking for work.
You Lucas?
Gilbert. Where is he?
Burke.
Hey!
I don't know.
Is that Lucas?
This guy uses a new man for each job, so let's just put one of us in there and see how close we can get.
Sir, I'm in.
No, bag it. You got no backup roster. Ladies and gentlemen, FBI.
Honestly, I'm asking for a job.
Really?
This is Antonio Mora. Sunday, how to get the best deal on your Valentine's Day flowers and learn how to keep them blooming. Also, the romantic couple Holly Robinson and Rodney Peet on Good Morning America Sunday here on ABC.